A question of trust. About the author. Victor Canning was a prolific British writer of short stories, novels, and thrillers who flourished in the 1950s, 1960s, and 1970s. He was personally reticent, writing no memoirs and giving relatively few newspaper interviews. Summary. Horace Danby was an unmarried, 50 years old man. He was a healthy guy, but in the months of summer, he suffered from the hay fever. Danby owned a business of lock making and had two or three helpers to work for him. He had a good reputation and respectable place in the society, but he couldn't be trusted as an honest man because about 15 years back, he had served a term in the prison library. He was doing well in business, but it couldn't finance him enough to support his weakness or hobby of collecting expensive books. Therefore, once a year, he used to do a planned robbery to acquire an amount which could last a year to carry on his hobby. It was the month of July when he schemed to rob Shotover Grange. He studied his target and its activities for 2 weeks and found that family was out in London. Two servants were left behind to look after the house. The day when the servants were out for the movie, he decided to take the advantage of the opportunity to rob the house. He hoped to find jewelry worth 15,000, which would help him to earn enough cash to last a year. Before entering the house, he wore gloves so that no fingerprints were left behind. Then he picked up the keys hung on the hook outside the kitchen and opened the door. He very well knew that the locker was in the drawing room behind the painting, as he had already gone through the layout of the house published in a magazine. Without making any noise, he carefully entered the drawing room, but the smell of the flowers kept in the drawing room tickled his nose, and he sneezed. Trying hard to control himself, he went inside the hall and cut off the burglar alarm. But on returning back to the drawing room, he couldn't stop himself from sneezing loudly because he was acutely allergic to the flowers kept in the drawing room. So he covered his face with a handkerchief. Suddenly he heard a female voice asking if he was inflicted by cold or hay fever. Without giving a second thought, he replied, "Hay fever," and sneezed again. The voice of the lady advised him a remedy and warned that sneezing in the profession of robbery is not good. A young and pretty lady dressed in red attire appeared in the doorway in front of him. She was with a pet dog that was lovingly rubbing against her and was obeying her commands as she moved towards the fireplace. The lady firmly said that she was thankful to be back on time to catch him red-handed. She further said she was going to hand over him to the police to save the society from the criminals like him. Listening this, Horace got frightened as he wasn't expecting anyone in the house. He took the lady as an owner of Shotover Grange. He pleaded that he wasn't a professional robber or a threat to the society. He tried to explain the reason of stealing and requested her to let him go. He even promised not to repeat this act again. The lady smartly took out the cigarette from the silver box kept on the table. To please her, Horace removed his gloves and took out a lighter from his pocket and offered her, and once again pleaded to set him free, as he didn't want to get in trouble. The lady in red agreed to set him free at one condition, if he helped her. She explained that she had promised her husband to keep her jewels in the bank, but she left them in the safe and now she wanted to wear them to a party tonight. Horace understood her confusion that she had forgotten the password of the safe and needed his help. He replied that he can break the safe within an hour if she allowed him. The lady hurriedly said not to worry, her husband is out for a month and before his return she will mend the safe. He trusted her and within an hour he opened the safe and gave the jewels to the lady and left the house happily. 2 days went by, he kept his promise made to the lady. But on the third day, he gave up to his passion of the book collection. He started to plan another robbery to break a safe. Unfortunately, his dreams got shattered when he saw police at the doorstep to arrest him on the charge of jewel robbery done in Shotover Grange, as his fingerprints were found all over the room. He tried to defend himself, but no one believed him. He found himself deceived when he heard the truth about the landlady of the house was 60 years old woman. He understood that the lady in red was a crook herself and she tricked him to open the safe without his gloves and smartly escaped with the entire loot. Now Horace is serving his sentence of assistant librarian in the prison. He often wonders and gets mad when someone talks about the honor among thieves. In the end, we can say that the crime done with any intention cannot be justified because it violates the rights and safety of others. Moral: crime never pays.